share our gifts in our communities and with the world. When you filled the room with your Pentecost Spirit that day, you helped us. You helped those people and helped us to see in a fresh way that each of us has something unique to share, and that your church is one in which diversity is valued and respected. We ask your blessing upon this church community today, and all those gathered and those who could not be here today. We thank you for the
perplexed. They asked one another, what does this mean? Some, however, made fun of them and said, is it too much wine? Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice and addressed the crowd. Fellow Jews and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you. Listen carefully to what I say. These people are not drunk as you suppose. It's only 9 in the morning. No, this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God said, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. I will show wonders in the heavens above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the great and glorious day of the Lord. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. And then 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 4 to 13. There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them, and in everyone, it is the same God at work. Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good. To one there is given, through the Spirit, a message of wisdom. To another, a message of knowledge by means of the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by that one Spirit. To another, miraculous powers. To another, prophecy. To another, distinguishing between spirits. To another, speaking in different kinds of tongues. And to still another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are the work of one and the same Spirit, and he distributes them to each one just as he determines. Just as a body, though one, has many parts, but all its many parts form one body, so it is with God. For we were all baptized by one Spirit, so as to form one body, whether Jews or Gentiles, slave or free, and we were all given the one Spirit to drink. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today, on Pentecost Sunday, we remember the story of the Spirit blowing over the people gathered that day. The sound of a strong wind, so strong, maybe a little like that gale that was blowing in Valley Castle, filled the entire house where they were sitting. Each of them was filled with the Holy Spirit, and suddenly they were able to communicate with all people They say that this day, Pentecost, was the day the church was really born. And what a way to begin. Pentecost is celebrated all over the world as the beginning of the church, and of God's Spirit blowing through the communities and giving us that new beginning. And when we look back at the starting point of the church, it's interesting to think of what that Pentecost moment actually highlighted. When the wind blew through, what happened exactly? What was so amazing and astonishing that filled them with such awe and wonder? The wind, yes. And what looked like flames on their heads, that was a bit unusual, definitely striking. But what was really amazing that day was that suddenly they could communicate with every person under heaven in their own language. Every person there in Jerusalem that day from every corner of the world could understand what was being said in their own native tongue. This was what caused all the excitement. When you think about it, the Holy Spirit could have done this or gone about this another way. God could have used this powerful moment to unite people under the same language so that they could communicate perfectly with each other, the same language. So God didn't use the same language, but this wasn't the case. This wasn't the way it happened. In this miracle, people could actually understand what was being said in their own languages, The unique character of each person's background and culture remained intact. What the arrival of the Holy Spirit did that day in that dramatic gust of wind was to honor and to value the uniqueness of each person present and the vibrant expressions from every nation under heaven. The amazement and astonishment that filled those gathered that day came from being able to connect with people in their glorious, beautiful diversity and variety. I love the image of the wind blowing through and reaching everyone present with their different backgrounds and cultures and perspectives. The Spirit of Pentecost blessed the diversity of the crowd present in Jerusalem that day. I've been reading up a little bit on the history of the Moravian Church, and I know not everyone here has grown up in the Moravian Church. Maybe you've joined in later years, but I'm not sure how much you know about the history of the Moravian Church, but I've been finding it very fascinating. And I know that this moment in the early church is important to Moravians, as well as what came after, the way the early church gathered in small groups and shared possessions and meals together and committed to living in community together. The new life that was born that day for the church moved on in those early Christian communities, and Moravian settlements and churches like Gracehill are built on that model of the early church. And isn't it inspiring to look back and remember the Spirit blowing that Pentecost day and to recall the awe and wonder of that moment? When that early church discovered that day, and that Moravians continue to teach and to represent, is that concept of the unity that can be found in diversity. Just as the Holy Spirit showed us on Pentecost, we don't need to be the same to be united. We see that in the concept of unitas fratrum in the Moravian Church, that name of the broader Moravian Church around the world, which is one international denomination, one international church in about 40 each of us has a room for different gifts, talents, skills, and a different set of knowledge or expertise, a unique perspective or experience. The Spirit doesn't ask us to be exactly the same as each other, but invites us to recognize each other and ourselves as unique, as precious, treasured individuals, no matter who we are or where we come from. That passage in Corinthians says there's a variety of gifts, but the same is. This reminds us that God doesn't want us all to blend into each other to the point of losing our sense of who we are. The Spirit honors our uniqueness and invites us to do the same. So both of today's passages, the Pentecost story and the First Corinthians passage, seem to be saying that we honor and value and take joy in the diversity in our midst, that we value the uniqueness of each individual in our communities. Now, you and I don't know each other. I have met a few of you a little bit here and there. But in the few times I've sat in those pews, I've noticed that this is the kind of church where each person seems to be valued for their unique gifts. And not only that, but the stranger who speaks with a different accent and comes from a different place is kindly welcomed. Each person in this church, whether a longtime member or a low-in, is valued for who they are. These are signs that the Spirit is growing in this church and any church that shows that same image. And we can look at it even more broadly, that each church or denomination within the Christian family has a unique gift to offer. I'm Presbyterian, and we Presbyterians certainly think we have a lot to offer, you know, but I have been struck by a unique character of the Moravian tradition that has been carried throughout the world for generations with gentleness and humility and compassion. What a gift to the wider church family. The Spirit invites us, like on that Pentecost day, to honor different expressions of the same truth, for we're all united around the story of Jesus. These are signs that the Spirit is growing in our church today. And to return to the Pentecost story, that wonderful story, it ends by quoting a passage from the prophet Joel in the Hebrew scriptures. I will pour out my Spirit on all people, on your sons and daughters, and they will prophesy. Your young ones will see visions. Your old ones will dream dreams. When the Spirit flows through us and fills us with wonder and amazement and astonishment at the unity that we can find in our diversity, when that holy breath of God inspires us and each one of us is capable of envisioning, envisaging, dreaming what the future might hold for the church and for the world. Each voice, each expression, each person in their uniqueness is a part of that vision for the future. And it's through honoring the different voices among us that we work the best for the world. The Spirit speaks to each of us, and also through each of us. God values each of our voices and expressions and gifts. And when we value these as well, this is a sign that the Spirit is growing in this church. So may God's Spirit flow through each one of us today, filling us with wonder, opening our eyes to see the unique gifts that each of us brings, and inspiring us to dream breathe your Spirit on us and fill us with new life and help us to do your will. You have blessed us with so much and we are grateful. We return a portion of what you have given us and we ask that you would bless it to further your work in this world. Amen. Eternal and loving God, may your Holy Spirit guide and sustain us in our daily lives, molding and shaping us into the people you call us to be. May we realize the uniqueness each of us has, and may we have room in hearts to share that with others. We pray that your Spirit would guide and shape and all the church communities who are recalling the Pentecost story today throughout the world. May we find unity in our diversity, recognizing and honoring the different perspectives and expression we all offer. We pray for all those in leadership and positions of responsibility throughout all sectors, that through your Spirit, they might seek the ways of justice and peace, mercy and love. May your Spirit bring forth those visions and dreams of a better future. Be with all who are grieving today, that they might be strengthened and comforted by your Spirit. Be with those who are alone, isolated, or struggling in any way. May your healing presence sustain them and provide a light. May your Spirit grow within us today, inspiring us and inviting us into the days ahead. Apologies for skipping him there, but I was so eager to get going with my sermon. I guess I skipped that. Now may the Holy Spirit blow through us, refreshing us and inspiring us to be a part of God's work in the world. And may